Hello, everyone.
This is with Jeff, which is, I mean, that movie is founding out so people can stop asking you, when are you making another Independence Day?
Yes, because... did you say Independence Day 4? You did. She did, didn't she? Well, people haven't been asking me, when are we going to see that Independence Day 4? I have not heard that question. You're the first to say that. But I have, just, this is not scientific, but anecdotally, in the last 20 years, people were very unexpectedly, particularly delighted by the first one, you know, it exceeded expectations. And then in the last 20 years, yeah, people come up and say, oh boy, we like that, are there going to be more? And now it's coming out. 20 years to the dead, kind of perfect timing. Right? So, yeah, thrilling.
So excited to hear that. Are we the first people you've talked to today?
No.
No? Are we the most interesting? Yeah. Is it about, no. All right. Good. Oh, we're the best looking. Oh, thank you.
What's this? A follow-up question. I think a follow-up question. What? What's this? What?
So.
Yes. Are you leading a tour? Oh, no, it's a... Everybody with seven, follow me. No, it's a selfie stick. Ah! Oh, yes.
So here's my question. How did you manage to hack an alien spaceship with 1980 technology?
1990.
Okay, she misspoke that. With 1990s technology. Going back to the first, this is a question about the first movie. I forget. What the heck did we do? I was just pretending at the time, too. You know more about that. I don't know. What did I do? It didn't make sense how I was going to... I don't know. You know, it was just pretend. And I hacked it, and we fixed their wagons. Those dirty aliens.
We killed them. Yes. Yes, over here. What's your name and where are you from? I never met you before in my life, have I? All right. Is this your car keys? I mean, no. Go ahead.
Why aren't we on a cruise ship? We should be on a cruise ship.
Really? Yes, ma'am.
I don't see any cameos from you in any of the Star Trek reboots.
I'm not allowed to talk about Star Trek right now. It's a whole other franchise. And can you expect to see me? Can I expect to see me is the question. I have no idea. They've never asked me to do any of that.
Yeah, okay.
Really?
Really?
Oh, no, no. You know what? It's fine if you thought that. Apparently, a lot of people thought that incorrectly. Yeah. No, I was just kidding. Yeah, exactly. Me? Yes, ma'am. I'm sorry, Jeff. This is Jeff Goldblum.
I'm up. Okay, yeah.
Delightful. He's fantastic. He's fantastic. We got together with him in 96. He had done, what, Stargate before and something else? Universal Soldier. But he was at the beginning of his journey, which we now see is epic and special. His oeuvre. You've been trying to fit in that word all day.
Finally,
he does have an oeuvre. Yes, but at that moment it was, you know, he was a new voice, wasn't he? And I think this particular delightful romantic disaster thing he made fresh. And yes, and he's so I was delighted to do that. And with him, with all his new prowess and new toys, you know, special effects wise. But he's the same. He's particular. Do you know him? Have you seen him? Well, he is particularly creative, childlike, enthusiastic, passionate, kind, teacherly. I learned a lot from him and have a blast hanging out with him. He's soulful, wise, a wonderful human being, kind and creative, just
he's
wonderful.
Smart. He's smart.
He's so smart. And he tells you stories about, you know, all the people not here he's worked with, and you know, he's very so good.
Yeah, yeah. Do I have a question for me? Yeah. What? This is it? I'm just getting warmed up. Well, let us just say
we're scratching the surface.
We love the Golden Globes. Thank you so much.
Wrong
crowd. Oh, sorry. Liam Hemsworth, terrific young actor, going to be a big star. I think this is going to be the movie that really catapults him into Chris Hemsworth territory.
Bless you. Thank you. Thank you. They have to pull us off. Oh, thank you. That was the most fun I ever had.